Alright, so here will be a review of the 150th scale KCX240B long reach produced by Conrad. This model seems to be on everybody's list to get, but including myself, I just couldn't seem to buy it, but I finally did. I'm definitely glad that I did purchase it. And I'll start off with this review by showing you the functions, which this model definitely exceeds on how functions should be on every excavator model. So, obviously, the tracks roll, and they roll very smooth, even on this paper surface. But, anyway, boom raises all the way. This will kind of be a hard review to do. Stick comes out, and it comes out perfect. I do wish it came out a little bit further, but really couldn't ask for more. And then it comes in super far. The bucket, which is my favorite, curls in this far, and then it curls out that far. And I think that's very good, because a lot of times you see these long reach working in conditions where everything sticks to the bucket. So, to display it in a diorama or even on your shelf with the bucket curled all the way out, I picture this machine slamming the bucket back and the stick wobbling and everything like that, and it does. It seems like the model even does that. Anyway, it also rotates a 360, and it goes down extremely far. It even comes down so far that the bottom of the boom actually hits the undercarriage. That's how far it comes down. So we'll have to bring it down like this. And if you notice, you could spin the tracks and they won't hit the floor. That's how far it actually comes down. It rests on the back of the counterweight. So it's perfect for displaying in dioramas. It comes down so far that you can't even see it in the camera anymore. It probably comes down 16 inches. And I know that seems almost impossible, but it really does do that. Anyway, next I will show you the build quality. So the build quality on this case is of any Conrad model. And if you own a Conrad model, it's the exact same build quality. It's perfect. Model is 99% metal. I could actually only count a few things that are plastic besides the cylinders. Tracks are good, but again, like most Conrad models, the way that they paint them, it shows the pads that are still in the die cast, and that kind of annoys me a little bit, because you look at it and then you see that silver and it looks like a bad weathering job, but you can't really do anything about it. The railing, which is on the other side, which I will show you right here, is metal, surprisingly. Honestly, when I took it out of the box, I thought that it would have been plastic. And the exhaust here seems to be metal as well. The entire boom is also metal, and that's a good thing because there's really no risk of it breaking. I always, you know, thought that it would break, but it's not going to break. Some of the pins aren't painted, but, you know, doesn't really matter since they are hollow. The only plastic things are the cab guard, which I'll go over that in the detail, and then a little plastic thing that holds the stick for transport. Now I'll get to the detail. So as for the detail of it, typical Conrad model, really not too much detail. Before I made this review, I kind of wanted to imply that the build quality is better than the detail, and that it is the case here. No pun intended. But anyway, the detail of it includes one of the things that I feel is a good touch, but then I feel I don't know why they included it, is the cab guard. And I actually went to take it off, but then I realized that I had to do a review for YouTube, and I kept it on to keep the model stock. I don't know why they put it on. I guess it's a nice touch. If someone wants it, they could always just take it off. But I just don't see why it is on there. Besides that, the tracks are great. They even include a tensioner. And this is a very tight tensioner. And the tracks are very nicely made. I don't think you'll have a problem breaking them at all if you do mess around with your models. As for the body, you could kind of tell there's a little etched detail right there. Counterweight, pretty plain, you know, just a normal case counterweight. And the right side has a little door to what would be a compartment. The steps, as you can tell right here, they have a little top, little, I guess, etched thing. I don't know what you would even call that. And then the top has a little compartment for the fuel, and then these little things up top, like the step has. The engine compartment here has these little things that would, I guess, would be a grill, but they're not really through. And the exhaust right here. Surprisingly, it does have hydraulic lines. And they do run up the boom to the casted parts on top of the boom. And as you can tell right here, they just run to the top. There are no hydraulic lines that lead to the cylinder to curl the stick, but there are hydraulic lines that lead to the cylinder to curl the bucket, which you would think that they would have put them to the stick, but I guess they kind of just skipped out on that. You could tell the pins aren't painted as well, but it really doesn't matter because they are barely noticeable. This piece right here is for when you transport it on a lowboy. You would just clip it on like that, and then the stick wouldn't wobble. And when it's not in use, you just push it up right there. As for the stick, it's got the hydraulic lines. They run down the back of it. And then this little piece right here is actually for when you rest it on the ground or on the lowboy. The bucket is one of my more favorite things on any newer model that I've got lately. Mainly because I don't have an excavator with a ditch cleaning bucket that doesn't tilt. And I like this a lot because a lot of times you see long reach working in ditches or ponds and whatnot. It would have been nice if they would have put a quick coupler and a normal general purpose bucket with it. But this is just the way they offer the model, and it's either you buy it or you don't. You could also tell it's made for working ponds and whatnot, because there really isn't any wear plating on it. It tilts in and tilts back very far, but as for wear plating and whatnot, it really doesn't have much. It's just flat, as you could tell from right here. But surprisingly, half of the pins on the bucket and linkage are painted, and the other half aren't. As you can tell, these two are painted and then those aren't, so I don't know what they did there either. But regardless, still a really nice model. And now I get to the whole issue of is it worth it? So the whole idea of is the model worth it, I definitely say it's worth it. It's definitely, without a doubt, one of those models that you just have on your list to get, but you never get because it's just there and who knows why. I mean, I have a ton of those models, but it's definitely worth it. I bought this one for $164, which was beyond worth it because I know I'm going to enjoy this model for a while. Someone in the comments I know is going to ask if it flips or tilts or if the hydraulic holds. Hydraulics are perfect. It does come off the undercarriage when you have it like this. This is completely stretched out and the undercarriage is turned like that, but if you have the undercarriage straight, it doesn't. It's by far worth it. There aren't that many long reach models out there. If you're debating on whether to get the Motor Art JCB long reach or this one, do not get the JCB long reach. I had that one and this one makes that one look like a toy. So $165, definitely worth it. And there's really nothing I could really say about it that's bad. And hope you enjoyed this review, and hopefully this will lead more people to getting this model, because it doesn't seem like there are that many people that own this.